All right. So good afternoon, class. For today, we'll be discussing about our first module for our subject about Philippine IT laws and policies. So at the end of this lesson, you're able to highlight the different laws relating to information technology in the Philippines. And of course, we'll be describing the different IT laws in the Philippines. As part of the introduction, so considering that Philippines is a third world country, it is attempting to keep up with the rapidly expanding ICT industry. As a result of the industry's importance, the government began drafting laws and bills to protect its citizens from the foreboding dangers associated with ICT, as well as provisions to assist citizens in becoming more integrated into the thriving industry. However, there is no perfect law that prevents them from being amended in the future if circumstances change. Yan. So napakahalaga na pag-aralan natin itong mga laws na to na related sa ICT kasi alam naman po natin na tayo po ay nasa never-ending evolving technology. At sabi dito, bagamat may mga bills na, may mga laws na, so we're not yet sure kung ito na ba talaga yung mga laws and bills even in the future. So laging subject ito for amendments. Kasi depende na nga po kung ano nangyayari ngayon. So these are the different IT laws in the Philippines na kailangan natin pag-aralan. So we have the e-commerce law, RA 8792, the Intellectual Property Code of the Philippines, RA 8293, Optical Media Act of 2002, RA 9239, Data Privacy Act of 2012, RA 10173, Department of Information and Communication Technology Act of 2015, or the RA 10844, and lastly, Cybercrime Prevention Act of 2012, RA 10175. So isa-isahin natin to, tong different IT laws na to na popular and related sa ICT. Then we'll be having our activity next week para mas madali nating ma-appreciate what are these IT laws that we needed to understand. So umpisahan na natin with the e-commerce law. So yung e-commerce law, also known as the Republic Act of 8792, recognizes the importance of ICT in nation building while also setting the goal of making the country more information friendly. Yan. So the e-commerce law emphasizes the importance of strict authorizations for electronic documents as well as the authentication process that goes along with them, as well as the promotion of the use of ICT in government and the general public according to the Act's sponsors. So under the law, the e-commerce law applies to any kind of data message and electronic document used in the context of commercial and non-commercial activities to include domestic, ibig sabihin local yan, and international dealings or abroad, transactions, arrangements, agreements, contracts, and exchanges, and storage of information. So, ganun kalawak yung scope ng e-commerce law. For example, existing social media accounts, mobile wallet banking services such as GCash, yun yung very common sa atin, Paymaya, coins.ph, etc., and existing phone numbers can all be used to verify the authenticity of documents among other methods. Yan, kaya nga 'di ba, halimbawa ako, kung may mga bank transactions ka, may mga credit card transactions ka, 'di ba? Don't you realize may mga OTP or one-time PIN to ensure na ikaw talaga 'yung nagta-transact noon. The salient features of this act are the following. First, it gives legal recognition of electronic data messages, electronic documents, and electronic signatures. So stipulated in Section 6 to 13. Allows information of contracts in electronic form, mentioned in Section 16, and makes banking transactions done through ATM, switching networks absolute once consummated, as stipulated in Section 16. So iyon po yung patungkol sa e-commerce law. The next one is about Intellectual Property Code of the Philippines, which is RA 8293. Sabi dito, this act shall be known as the Intellectual Property Code of the Philippines. It is an act prescribing the Intellectual Property Code and this and establishing the Intellectual Property Office, providing for its powers and functions and for other purposes. Ako, nakabisit na ako ng IPO kasi I needed to get serial number para dun sa pinapublish na book or journal nung LPU Laguna during that time, considering na ako yung intellectual property coordinator. So lahat andun yun sa National Library. Then kailangan isurrender mo sa kanila yung files na gusto mong bigyan ng serial number. It shall protect and secure the exclusive rights of scientists, inventors, artists, and other gifted citizens to their intellectual property and creations, particularly when beneficial to the people for such periods as provided in this act. So yan, tayo mga computer engineers, di ba? So who knows? Kasi pag sinabing engineer, scientist din tayo, inventors din tayo. So we are gifted citizens, technologically inclined persons na maaring makaisip ka or maka-invento ka ng isang technology that you could apply for patent or even reserve for intellectual property right. Republic Act number 9239 naman is pertaining to the Optical Media Act. It is an act regulating optical media, reorganizing for this purpose the Videogram Regulatory Board, providing penalties therefore and for other purposes. It is also known as the Optical Media Act of 2003. So this act declares the guiding principles of the country to ensure the protection and promotion of intellectual property rights. It includes the regulation in manufacturing, mastering, replication, importation, and exportation of optical media. Syempre kailangan, kung na-apply na natin for patent or na-apply na natin yung copyright for that specific innovation, so it has to be protected. Yan. So yun yung kinocover ng Optical Media Act of 2002. In the Philippines, there is a vast problem in duplicating optical media. Kasi diba, many people are imitating mostly DVDs for the sake of business. Punta na lang tayo doon sa SM, diba? Dyan sa palengke sa may Victory Mall. Ang dami doon mga nagtitinda ng mga pirated. For example, they record a certain video file, burn it to a DVD or CD, and sell it for a lower price. However, this is not in favor of the said law. It is against this act to replicate or even imitate an optical media because it is not right or legal to obtain some records to a person without any permission. If a person wants to copy a certain file, he or she must give credits to the owner. Ayan, so be careful on that. So maaring hindi tayo yung nagba-violate, pero maaring tayo nag-i-enjoy na kumonsumo ng ganitong mga imitations kasi nga mas mura siya. Next is, this is very interesting, the Data Privacy Act of 2012 or the RA 10173. It protects the privacy of individuals while ensuring free flow of information to promote innovation and growth. It regulates the collection, recording, organization, storage, updating or modification, retrieval, consultation, use, consolidation, blocking, erasure or destruction of personal data. Oh, tinamang tindi, no? And it ensures that the Philippines complies with international standards set for data protection through National Privacy Commission or the NPC. NPC is the country's privacy watchdog, an independent body mandated to administer and implement the DPA and to monitor and ensure compliance of the country with international standards set for data protection. So even in the industry, just like in our company, we practice, we value Data Privacy Act. So hindi kami basta nagbibigay ng mga personal information. Even ngayon pag nagpa-file kami ng leave, halimbawa, gusto kong mag-leave. So nasa akin yun, kung gusto kong i-disclose, bakit ako magli-leave? Diba, magli-leave ba ako dahil pupunta ako ng out of town or kailangan kong magpahinga or so on. So pwede ko siyang hindi i-disclose because of Data Privacy Act. So next is the Department of Information and Communication Technology Act of 2015 or the RA 10844, otherwise known as the Department of Information and Communications Technology, which was signed into law on May 23, 2016. So latest lang to. The department is the primary policy, planning, coordinating, implementing, and the administrative entity of the executive branch that will plan, develop, and promote the national ICT development agenda. So on October 17, 2016, DICT Secretary Rodolfo A. Salalima and DBM Secretary Benjamin Jokno signed the implementing rules and regulations. So meron na po tayong DICT. Sabi ko nga sa inyo, very active. They have a lot of webinars available in Facebook that we just have to join. Then, bibigyan tayo ng certificate. Aligning with the current administration's ICT agenda, it will prioritize the following. Development of a national broadband plan to accelerate the deployment of fiber optic cable and wireless technologies to improve internet speed. O, di ba? May ganong batas. Merong ganun palang ang function na ginagawa ang DICT. Provision of Wi-Fi access at no charge in selected public places including parks, plazas, public libraries, schools, government hospitals, train stations, airports, and seaports. Temo, no charge. Dapat merong Wi-Fi access dun sa mga selected public places. And of course, development of a national ICT portal. With the creation of the DICT, the following agencies were abolished and their powers, functions, applicable funds, and appropriations. Ibig sabihin ng appropriations, yung budget for them. Records, equipment, property, and personnel transferred to the department. Yan, so nalipat yung budget sa DICT from Information and Communication Technology Office or ICTO, National Computer Center, NCC, National Computer Institute, NCI, Telecommunications Office or TELOF, National Telecommunications Training Institute or NTTI, all operating units of the Department of Transportation and Communications, DOTC, with functions and responsibilities dealing with communications. So lahat po yun na-abolish and then yung kanilang mga functions, lahat na-centralized doon sa DICT. The following agencies are attached to the Department for Policy and Program Coordination. Siyempre, andyan pa rin yung National Telecommunications Commission or the NTC, National Privacy Commission, and the Cybercrime Investigation and Coordinating Center. Pursuant to Section 20 of RA number 10844, creation of the DICT, the appropriation of the new department shall be taken from the current fiscal year's appropriation of the ICTO. Next is the Cyber Crime Prevention Act of 2012 or the RA 10175. Basically common to sa atin, it addresses crimes committed against and through computer systems on December 12, 2012. It includes penal substantive rules, procedural rules, and also rules on international cooperation. Amendatory bills on cybercrime investigations are under work in the Philippines with new provisions being introduced on procedural powers, responsibilities, and extradition. The aim is for the amendments to provide a structured approach for prosecutors and investigators on cybercrime investigations and to further align national legislation. So cybercrime, also called computer crime, is basically the use of computer as an instrument to further illegal ends such as committing fraud, trafficking, child pornography, intellectual property violations, stealing identities, or violation of privacy. Tinan mo yun, no? Even yung pag-steal ng identity or violation of privacy, mga ginagawa ng mga poster, di ba? The difference between traditional criminal offenses from cybercrime is the use of the computer in committing such offenses. So, andun yung involvement ng paggamit ng computer. So, basically, these are the key provisions of the Cybercrime Prevention Act of 2012. Illegal access, is basically the unauthorized entry into computer systems or networks. Illegal interception is the unauthorized interception of communication, often involving the unauthorized monitoring of data transmissions. Data interference is the unauthorized manipulation or alteration of electronic data. System interference is the unauthorized disruption or interference with the functioning of computer systems or networks. Misuse of devices is the inappropriate or unauthorized use of electronic devices. Cyber squatting is registering, using, or selling a domain name with the intent to profit from the goodwill of someone else's trademark. Computer-related forgery is creating, altering, or using purge electronic documents or data. Computer-related fraud is deceptive practices conducted through electronic means to gain something of value. Computer-related identity theft is illegally acquiring and using someone else's personal information for fraudulent activities. Cyber sex is engaging in sexual explicit activities through electronic communication. Child pornography is the creation, distribution, or possession of explicit materials involving minors. Libel is defamation through written or published false statements that harm a person's reputation. Aiding or abetting in the commission of cybercrime is assisting or facilitating others in the commission of cybercrimes. Attempt in the commission of cybercrime is the unsuccessful effort to commit a cybercrime. And corporate liability is the legal responsibility of corporations for cybercrimes committed by their employees or on their behalf. So, ang dami nun. So, ano ba yung mga advantages? Siyempre, cyber sex, cyber bullying, child pornography are now offenses. And such offenders can be punished. So the children's rights are protected by this act. Diba? Gusto natin yun, yung mga children natin, they are protected. All kinds of businesses using the internet as a medium are protected by this act. Provisions of this act now define the offense of cyber squatting and this deters people from the act of cyber squatting. Provisions that penalizes online identity theft, this provision protects the individual's privacy and its protection. Ano naman yung disadvantages? Ito yung lagi. So, merong ambiguity. Pag sinabing ambiguity, merong unclear, parang cloud. In terms given in the act, such as the term online libel is not defined anywhere, which can lead to different interpretations. Ambiguity can be seen in the provision of real-time data collection. The ambiguity in the act may lead to the freedom of speech. The ambiguities, like the absence of a proper definition of online libel, may lead to confusion. Sometimes, the expression of some truth may be misinterpreted as libel. People may be restrained from expressing themselves. The implementation and execution of this act yearly cause a huge cost to the government. So, yun yung mga disadvantages. This is the reference that I have used for our discussion. At ito naman yung activity natin for next week. So, we'll be having a role play. Dun sa role play, gusto ko na ipakita ninyo yung Philippine IT laws and policies. So, meron tayong anim. Yung e-commerce law will be performed by Group 1. The Intellectual Property Code of the Philippines will be performed by Group 2. Optical Media Act will be performed by Group 3. Data Privacy Act will be performed by Group 4. The ICT Act will be performed by Group 5. And the Cybercrime Prevention Act will be performed by Group 6. So basically, isip pa ng isang scenario showing na itong mga batas na ito ay na-violate doon sa inyong role play. So I think that's it for this afternoon. Thank you for listening.